Now here's our reporter, Laura Windsor, with a story for women.
Painful intercourse can occur for a variety of reasons, ranging from structural problems to psychological concerns. We spoke with Dr. Lauren Streicher, an associate clinical professor of obstetrics and gynecology of Northwestern University's medical school. We asked her about women who have problems with painful intercourse.
Between 25 and 50% of women have problems with painful intercourse. We think in terms of postmenopause as being the most common time that a woman has painful sex, and that's true. Because of the hormonal changes, a lot of women have what we call vaginal atrophy, and I very often refer to as genital dryness. But it's not just midlife and older women. Young women can have painful intercourse as well. Things like birth control pills, postpartum, and a lot of medications that even a young woman might be prescribed can impact on her sexual health. The medical term for painful intercourse is dyspareunia, and there are really two different categories. Superficial dyspareunia means that there's pain on entry. Deep dyspareunia, on the other hand, is he gets in just fine, but then there's terrible pain with any thrusting moment, which can sometimes last even beyond the time of intercourse. And some women, of course, have both kinds of dyspareunia. When we think in terms of the superficial dyspareunias, very often it is because of genital dryness, vaginal dryness. But a lot of times it's a protective mechanism, because if the body is anticipating that there's going to be pain, your body's not stupid, and it's going to try and avoid that pain by having all the muscles constrict down. And this is a situation called vaginismus. Deep dyspareunia is because sometimes there's something wrong in the pelvis. It may be endometriosis. It may be a large ovarian cyst. It may even be a gastrointestinal problem. Almost any medical condition can impact. But the same thing that happens with vaginismus can also happen deep in the pelvis. Your pelvic muscles can actually contract inappropriately, again, as a protective mechanism to keep the painful thing from occurring. When that happens, like a painful contraction anywhere in the body, there can be release of lactic acid. And in turn, lactic acid can cause even more painful sex, and including can cause superficial dyspareunia as a result.
Dr. Lauren Streicher talks about pelvic floor weakness.
Pelvic floor weakness isn't just about pain during intercourse. The same women that have difficulty with sexuality because of a weak pelvic floor are very often the same women that have problems with incontinence. And it's because you need a strong pelvic floor that works in a coordinated fashion to not only prevent the loss of urine, but also to be able to relax so that intercourse is comfortable. The other problem, though, that can happen if someone has a dysfunctional or weak pelvic floor is the inability to have an orgasm. Because what an orgasm is are the physical things that happen at the peak of excitement when the muscles become engorged with blood, and then there's a contraction and a release. And this takes a lot of muscle coordination. And if someone has weak pelvic floor muscles, it's just not going to happen. When we think in terms of strengthening a pelvic floor muscle, it's really like strengthening any other muscle in your body. Now, women are told to do Kegel exercises all the time, and theoretically, that should help. A Kegel exercise, of course, is contracting the pelvic floor muscles. Women are very often told to do it as if they're trying to stop the flow of urine, but that doesn't really work. And the reason it doesn't work is because over 50% of women have been shown to not do their Kegels properly. Sometimes it's because they haven't been given the proper instructions, but sometimes it's because their pelvic floor muscles are so weak that they're not able to contract them and release them in any kind of a coordinated fashion. There's a new device called Apex, and the way that it works is this device is placed into a woman's vagina, inflated so that it fits the woman's vagina perfectly, and then there's little electrical stimulation that's delivered to the pelvic floor muscles, causing the pelvic floor muscles to contract and release in a coordinated fashion. In addition, there's resistance, passive resistance, because it's not enough that it does it for a woman, she needs to know how to do it herself. And the beauty of this device is that once the muscles get the idea of how to contract and release, then she can try it on her own.
Dr. Streicher tells us the benefits of strengthening the pelvic floor muscles.
her urinary continence will be better, and we hope that sex will be more comfortable. And for a woman who's not able to have an orgasm, very often the strengthening the pelvic floor muscles will allow that to happen. We also know, though, that a woman needs clitoral stimulation in order to have an orgasm, and there is a device which is the sister to Apex, which is called Intensity. And the only difference is that there is a clitoral stimulator as well to give the woman the extra intensity that she needs in order to be able to have a healthy, strong orgasm.
Remember to consult with your doctor if you are experiencing painful intercourse, because treatment options focus on the underlying cause and can help eliminate or reduce this common problem. For the American Health Journal, I'm Laura Windsor.